Hello students, this is Anjali Divakar. I am going to cover a truss portion of analysis of structure from engineering mechanics. Today I'm going to cover a truss part actually. There are three portions in analysis of structure: analysis of truss, analysis of frame, and analysis of cables. Okay. Truss is an engineering structure designed to support loads acting on it. It is formed by by thin slender members. See, this portion is being called as member. Okay, they are thin, and thin means which is having lesser thickness. Okay, and slender means cross section is much lesser than the third dimension. Okay, which are pin connected at ends. It is being pin connected means hinge joint is there at the end, okay, forming a joint. These dots are being called as a joint, and the portion between these two joints is being called as a member. Load acts only on joint and not on a member. Specialty of a truss is that the member are designed to carry only axial forces and not a lateral forces, okay. This red portion is being called as a support. These columns will be there, and it is being hinged, or roller support will be there. Okay, it is equally placed, or sometimes some lesser or higher different spacing will be there. Okay, this skeleton will be being placed over here and here. Then roofing material will be placed on it. So where we can find this kind of structures: roof cover of railway station, railway platform, roof cover of industrial sheds, roof cover of cycle shed. Even electrical transmission tower, bridges of truss are also examples of trusses. Analysis of truss. This involves calculations of support reactions. As I told you, these are the supports. See, this is a hinge support, say, and this is a roller support. Then we are supposed to find out the two reactions at this point and one reaction at this point. By considering only external loading, loads will act at a joint, and we are going to consider it. Then after that, the member force coming in a member, forces in members are also being worked out. Forces coming in a member, whether they are tensile or compressive, are also worked out. There are a few assumptions in analysis of truss. All the members of the truss lie in a one plane. Then all the loads on the truss lie in a one plane of truss. In the plane of truss, members of a truss are joined at the end of internal hinges, known as the pins. Loads act only at joints and not directly on the members. See, what will happen if it acts on a member? Previously, I told you those are the thin and slender members. What will happen if we abruptly load act on a member? They may get buckle. Okay, for that reason, load will act only at joints. Each member is two force body, therefore resulting in axial forces, which may be tensile or compressive. I have shown you in this diagram, one force will be from this direction and another force will be from this direction. For that reason, it is a two force body member. Then truss is statically determined. Please understand this concept. If the truss can be solved by using only three conditions of equilibrium, then that truss is a statically determinate. If we are unable to solve by using only conditions of equilibrium, then that truss is being called as a statically indeterminate. There are three types of trusses: perfect truss, redundant truss, and deficient truss. One equation, standard equation, is given to us: M minus 2J is equal to 3. 3 is a number of equilibrium conditions. J is the number of joint and M is the number of members. If the members are equal or equal to 3, means equal as required, then that truss is called as a perfect truss. Or the truss solves this equation or satisfies this condition, then that truss is being called as a perfect truss, except for cantilever truss. For cantilever truss, this number will become 4. Okay. Redundant truss is if the members are greater than 3. Okay, or the members are greater than required. Deficient is members are lesser than required. Then that truss is being called as a deficient truss. There are two methods of analysis of truss: graphical and analytical. Previously, graphical method was also there. By using drafter, I'm drawing with scale. We were able to find out the magnitude of force in the member. But right now, only analytical method is there for our study purpose. There are two types of methods in analytical method, joint and section. In joint method, few steps are there which are to be followed. First of all, we are supposed to find out the geometry, missing geometry given to your skeleton or truss. Then after that, find out the reactions of support by using conditions of equilibrium. That is summation Fx, summation F1, summation moment. Considering external loading only, we are supposed to find out the reactions by considering only external loading. Means the loads already given in your problem are external loading. Acting on your joint are external loading. Then consider that joint which is having only two unknowns. Means if we go to this diagram, see, this is your support. We'll find out support reactions. See, say this is a hinge support, so two reactions will be there. We'll find out by considering the loads coming on your skeleton. Then we'll go to this joint as only two members are connected to it. Two support reactions are known to us right now and two unknowns will be there. So we'll go to this joint first. Then we'll come to this joint where this member is known to me now. Only two unknowns will be there. In this way, we'll complete the truss. Clear? We'll go to that joint which is having only two unknowns. Then draw FBD of that joint, apply conditions of equilibrium, find out unknown force of that member. Again, go to that joint which is having again two unknowns and apply conditions of equilibrium, find out unknown forces in members, mark whether it is tensile or compressive. Complete the truss, find out the forces of all members marked on main diagram and tabulate the result. Tabulation means what? We'll consider all the forces, all the members in this table. Then we'll work out the magnitude, whatever we have worked out in the calculations. Then we'll mark its nature, whether it is tensile or compressive. Means what? If the force is coming towards your joint, it is a compressive. If it is going away from your joint, then it is a tensile. That's all from my side. Thank you very much. Keep learning and happy learning. Thank you.